Good morning, students. We are talking about food security and nutrition under economics lesson 3. In the last class, we talked about purchasing power parity, factors affecting purchasing power, agriculture policy, and multidimensional nature of poverty. Now, we'll move on into the next concepts of status of nutrition and health status in Tamil Nadu, and some important nutritious program in Tamil Nadu. We'll see one by one. The first topic is about status of nutrition. Food security also includes nutrition security. So, what is nutrition security? That is the physical and economic and social access to a balanced diet is called nutrition security. Physical, economic and social access. So, considering this balanced diet. Balanced diet consists of variety of different types of foods and providing adequate amount of nutrients necessary for good health. That is called balanced diets. That is, an adequate amount of nutrients necessary for the good health is called a balanced diet. Considering the nutritious status of the population has not shown a level of improvement in India. In 2015 and 16, 27% of rural women and 16% of urban women, so urban means city areas, were counted as undernourished or chronically energy deficient by the National Family Health Survey. So according to the National Family Health Survey, 27% of rural women and 16% of urban women were considered as undernourished. Then, while we are considering the reproductive group of women, that is the age between 15 to 49 years in both rural and urban India, nearly half of the women were anemic in 2015 and 16. So, anemic is another drawback of the people. Then, considering the children, about 60% of the rural and 56% of urban children are counted to be anemic in the same year, 2015 and 16. So, often I am using a term called anemic. What is anemic? Anemic is nothing but, that is, it is due to lack of iron and due to lack of red blood cells in the body, and this leads to reduced oxygen flow to the body's organ. So that means we'll feel tired always. That's the meaning of anemic. Another indicator of nutrition deficiency among children is underweight. That is weight in relation to age. In India, in same 2015 and 16 table shows, 20% of children in rural and urban India are estimated to be underweight. So both in rural and urban area, we can see the children with underweight problem. So here, due to the nutritious deficiency, that leads to anemic and underweight among the children as well as women. That is the status of nutrition in India. Nutrition plays a crucial role in human health and well-being. At the national level, despite higher economic growth, improvements in human development indicators like nutrition levels of the population has been unacceptably slow. So, considering the level of economic growth and human development in our country, the nutrition security, that is nutritious level, is considerably very slow in India. A large number of children are stunted. A large number of Indian children are stunted. Stunted means here they are prevented from growing due to lack of this kind of nutritious food that prevent them from growing. A substantial number of Indian children and women are underweight. anemic and suffer from micronutrient deficiency. So here micronutrient means considering all types of vitamins, that is vitamin A, B, D, like that. So this all created lot of problem in the development of the people's health as well as development of the economy. To overcome these kind of problems, the central government and state government has been channelizing substantial resources into various health and nutritious scheme and programs in our country as well as in the state. Both central and state government, they plan many developmental programs. Under that, first one is ICDS, that is Integrated Child Development Services, then midday meals, then reproductive and child health programs, that is RCH, and National Rural Health Mission. So these are the programs sponsored by both central and state government to overcome the problem of the nutritious status of the people. While we are talking about the social welfare measures, Tamil Nadu has played a pioneering role in bringing about significant changes in the health and nutrition status of children under 6 years of age, pregnant women, lactating mothers, and adolescent girls. So Tamil Nadu has a pioneer to be first in the country to it make many changes for the health and nutritious status, and they consider for children and pregnant women. So children under age of 6 years, pregnant women, then lactating, that is those who are feeding mothers for their newborn babies, and adolescent girls. Adolescent means from 10 to 20 years of girls is considered as adolescent girls. So we have separate programs for the development of children and women in our Tamil Nadu. While we are talking about these programs, the performance of ICDS, that is Integrated Child Development Services. So under that ICDS, we have a separate program from the newborn baby, that is from 0 years to 3 years, and we have separate program for 3 to 6 years, and then from 6 to 12 years, like that, we have a child development program. So that is called Integrated Child Development Services. Then we have Puruchi Thalaivar MGR Nutritious Meal Program. So Nutritious Meal Program, so this will be given in every government schools. So they will give free meals to the children. So in Tamil Nadu is considered as one of the best in the country. So considering other states of India, Tamil Nadu is considered as the pioneer as well as best in the country. In Tamil Nadu, ICDS is being implemented through 54,439 child centers. So totally throughout in rural as well as in urban area, totally in Tamil Nadu we have 54,439 child centers. ICDS is now considered to be one of the world's largest program of its kind. So considering the world countries, our ICDS is considered as the world's largest program. Then Puruchi Thalaivar MGR Noon Meal Program, that is PTMGR-NMP, is considered to be the largest noon meal program in the country. That is Tamil Nadu. I told it is a pioneer as well as the best country state. So these are considered as best programs for the development of children and women in the state of Tamil Nadu. We'll talk about some important ongoing schemes in Tamil Nadu. That is, what are the schemes we are following in Tamil Nadu? Under Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy, whether you remember Muthulakshmi Reddy, that is the first woman doctor. So Muthulakshmi Reddy, maternity benefit scheme, financial assistance to tune of rupees 12,000 is being disposed to poor pregnant women. So maternity, so giving money assistance for the poor pregnant woman. So that is the first scheme. Then the Chief Minister's Comprehensive Health Insurance Scheme was launched in the state in 2011 and 12 with the aim to provide universal health care to all by providing free medical and surgical treatment. So that is under the Comprehensive Health Insurance Scheme. The government will distribute card, smart card, they will distribute a card, health card to the poor people. So with that they can take either treatment, free medical treatment, as well as for any surgeries they can use. So there is no need to pay any money under this. So they can give free treatment in private hospitals. So that is the important of our Comprehensive Health Insurance Scheme. Then third scheme is Tamil Nadu Health System Project has launched ambulance services at free of cost. That is our 108 emergency ambulances. So that is under a free of cost. There is no need to pay any money. So throughout rural and urban area, people are using this 108 ambulance services. Then the school health program emphasizes on providing comprehensive health care services to all students studying in government and government aided schools. So they are providing comprehensive health care services. Then the National Leprosy Eradication Program is being implemented in the state with the aim to detect and to provide sustained regular treatment to all leprosy patients. So considering the leprosy patients, here we have a leprosy eradication, that is removal of leprosy programs we are implemented in the state to, that is the main aim is to detect and to provide sustained regular treatment, because you know it, leprosy is also a vulnerable disease for the people, and due to that is also due to lack of some vitamins. So here the government of Tamil Nadu is caring about this leprosy patients. Now we'll talk about some nutritious program in Tamil Nadu. First one, Purachi Thalaivar MGR Nutritious Meal Program. So that is a midday meal program for the school children. That is from 1st standard to 12th standard, both in government and government aided school, they'll give free food. Then second one, National Program of Nutritional Support to Primary Education. So under primary education, that is from 1st standard to 5th standard, here providing food, along with that they are providing vaccines and iron tablets to the children. Then third one, General ICDS Project and World Bank Assisted Integrated Child Development Services. That is with the help of World Bank, Tamil Nadu government is providing Integrated Child Development Services. That is, we have separate programs for boys and girl children here from age of 0 to 17 years. Then Pradhan Mantri Gramodaya Yojana Scheme. Under that, here they are providing food for the elderly people. Then Tamil Nadu Integrated Nutritious Program and Midday Meal Program. Under these two schemes, the government of Tamil Nadu is providing food for the elderly person as well as medicines for the pregnant woman, and they will provide iron tablets to everyone, elderly as well as pregnant women, to maintain their health. These projects are useful for the people. So in today's class we finished with the status of nutrition among women, adolescent girls and children in both rural and urban areas. To overcome the problem, both the central government and state government initiated many welfare schemes like ICDS, that is Integrated Child Development Programs, Midday Meals Program, and Purachi Thalaivar MGR Noon Meal Program. These are the world famous programs started by Tamil Nadu, and we are the pioneer state among India. And By using this noon meal program, nearly 70% of school children, they used this noon meal program, and 42% of pregnant women and 30% of elderly people are getting benefit out of these projects. So government is making a new schemes and adopting many policies for the welfare of the people. I hope you understood this lesson. Thank you, Ma.